Yesterday I was talking to my daughters in the house, and I told them, I said, please, one day when you are married, marry a husband. Don't marry a Christian husband. Now, this is very controversial, but let me explain it. Don't marry a man because he's a Christian. Marry a man because he's a husband. Because there are many Christians who are good Christians, but they are bad husbands. They love God, but they don't love a woman. They love God, but they don't love a man. The fact that somebody is a good Christian doesn't mean the person will make a good husband. But you see, you can never marry an unbeliever, even if he's the best of a husband. As for if the person is an unbeliever, it's out. You cannot marry an unbeliever, no matter how the person packages himself or herself as a wife or husband. You understand? So, when it comes to husband, unbeliever is out. When it comes to wife, an unbeliever is out. Now, when you come into a church, don't marry a man or a woman simply because they love God. They may love God, but they don't love you. They may be good Christians, but they are bad husbands and bad wives. Oh, why do you want to marry him? We go to the same church. Are you sure it's enough? Why do you want to marry her? Oh, she fears the Lord. Those are the women. Can you imagine? You've married this woman. She loves the Lord. I agree. You are going near her. She says, today I'm fasting. Oh, but you didn't tell me you are going to fast today. The secret things belong unto the Lord, but those things that are revealed belong to us. The fact too that a man loves the Lord doesn't mean he will be a good husband. Listen, some of even preachers or pastors are the most terrible husband you can ever meet. They preach well, they teach well, they are anointed, they can cast out devil. But the same way they cast out devil is the same way they cast out woman. It's not part of him. He's not a man who will come to you and give you a peg. I love you. No. He loves the Lord. And then he loves his church members. You, the woman, you are not part of his equation. Oh, will you marry him? Yeah, I'll marry him. Oh, don't you see the way the guy is very busy in the church? Running around with cameras. He will shoot you. He will use a camera and shoot you in the house. He will give you video coverage. The fact that a person is busy doesn't mean he will be a good husband. Ohumpaye is a ohumpaye. And ore tongues. Ohumpaye na ore tongues. But here is a man, no attraction. He doesn't even know the size of his belt. He will wear the belt and about half of it is hanging here. Prayer warrior. When he wears a tie, it's the breastplate of righteousness. Tie easy. And I'll say, Abba. Now, Kwame, young boys, see the way I'm dressing, God looks on the heart. Man looks at the outward appearance. It is not the things that you see that are important. Now, Kwame, who in your haircut? You are Delilah. You want to cut my hair, and I'll lose my power. So, you see them, they say, I want to marry a Christian husband. I agree. Marry a Christian husband. If it's full, Christian, who is a husband? But don't marry a Christian because you think automatically he's a husband. I want to marry a Christian wife. Don't, no, she may be a Christian, but she's not a wife because her mouth is too sharp. Some of the Christian wives, when they shoot one or two arrows, the other day I heard mommy talking to her daughters in the house. They, you people, learn how to speak. Learn how to speak. And I told them, I said, see, all of you, when you are going to marry, I will talk to your fiancés. All of your character, I will tell them your character. I will give you the real value of what you are going to marry. There was a situation, I brought two of them to my office. I said, the man, you are like this. The woman, you are like this. If you people decide to marry, please, don't marry because of me. My hands are not in it. Because this kind of character doesn't marry.